The NHL is very sensitive to drama. And honestly, it can be seen as a massive flaw, as we've seen exponential growth from leagues like the NFL, UFC, and of course the NBA, because their many faces have boatloads of personality. But this is definitely a pretty controversial topic, because on one hand, many people like this about hockey, but there's no question that drama and player personality helps the sport grow. And this same mentality is a part of the entire system from start to finish, as we've seen prospects tank in their draft due to apparent attitude issues, regardless on whether or not those rumors were even correct. Because just take William Nylander as an example. Many scouts heading into the 2014 NHL draft had him as a top 3 talent, and it was well deserved. He was an elite winger who was displaying massive potential and had the production to back it up. Because in his draft year, Nylander was over a point per game in Ovechkin and had a very respectable 7 points in 22 SHL games. On top of a crazy U18 tournament where he put up 16 points in 7 games. However, due to quote-unquote cockiness, stem from overconfidence, and a rumor that he had issues in the locker room, many teams were unnecessarily scared off from William Nylander. And Nylander wouldn't fall far, as he went from the top 3 to being drafted 8th overall, but this was a prime example on how apparent attitude issues, real or not, can drastically affect a prospect's draft stock. In today's video, we're going to go over players who fell in their draft due to apparent attitude issues. So has your team ever had a prospect with attitude issues? Let me know and press subscribe for some more awesome hockey content. Let's get straight into this video. We'll start with the more recent case, which is Ryan Merkley. Because Merkley growing up was a phenom. He was a highly gifted offensive defenseman who had the tool set to be a cornerstone piece on any NHL team. As he was drawing serious comparisons to Erik Karlsson, and for good reason. As he dominated a midget, and would be drafted first overall in the OHL draft. And Merkley would go on to have a prolific rookie year with the Guelph Storm, as he put up 55 points in 62 games. However, this is where the issues started to emerge, as he started to develop a reputation for being a hard-to-coach player, and was known for throwing tantrums when things weren't going his way. But on the plus side, Merkley would still maintain that very elite playing style. And so heading into his draft, Merkley would still be regarded as a top talent in the entire class. Now scouts were aware of his attitude issues, but his talent still ranked in the top 3. Because in his draft year, Merkley would put up a very impressive 67 points in 63 games, so over a point per game on a team who didn't have a lot of high-end talent. And if Merkley wasn't dealing with this cloud of attitude issues, he would be a top 5 lock for the 2018 NHL draft. However, after being involved in more drama, including being benched and being healthy scratched as the best player on the team, which is honestly just ludicrous, Merkley would fall from the top 5 to 21st overall, where the Sharks would scoop him up, commenting that they did intensive questioning during the interview process. And so they were confident that they could guide him in the right direction. Because many scouts were not going to be surprised if he fell to the second round. And as for today, Merkley is still in junior, as he has been a stud this season with 76 points in 60 games. And it's also crazy to think a prospect like Merkley, who is so close to being an NHL star, so close to accomplishing everything he's been working on his entire life, but the only thing in his way is himself. Next, we have Oliver Shillington. And many of you may not even know the name, but in 2014, Oliver Shillington, by many scouts, was regarded to be right there behind Connor McDavid and Jack Eichel, as he was a dynamic skating defenseman who played in the SHL as a 16-year-old and was the youngest player in SHL history to score a goal. So on top of having an elite offensive tool set and one of the best transition games in the entire SHL, Shillington was set to be a top pick in the 2015 NHL draft, as he was projected to be a top 2 cornerstone defenseman. However, in his draft year, Oliver's stock would begin to tank after having a bad U18 tournament. On top of being injured and missing the World Juniors, and then having apparent attitude issues, which was heavily rumored, but no one knew exactly why. And many speculate that this rumor began to circulate, and so every team just started writing him off because of it. especially because he was playing in Sweden and he wasn't as accessible. So Shillington would fall from the top five to nearly a third round pick. And Shillington today has been bouncing back and forth from the AHL and NHL, and he has produced extremely well in the A, but with his toolset, if Oliver is able to keep developing his defensive game, he could be seen as a steal from the second round. Next, we have Tony DeAngelo. And just like Ryan Merkley, DeAngelo was an elite offensive defenseman coming from the OHL, as he put up 58 points a year before his draft year. But during the season, DeAngelo would develop a reputation for being uncoachable, as he was a very confident player who didn't like authority. So on top of his suspect defensive play and a temper that would cause DeAngelo to be suspended many times during his OHL career, DeAngelo would actually get worse in his draft year. Because even though he put up a very impressive 71 points in 51 games, DeAngelo would be suspended by his own team for off-ice issues and would even be suspended twice, including an 8-game suspension for harassing a referee and even his own teammate. As DeAngelo was suspended for using racism, sexism, or homophobic slurs, which was just unacceptable. And so even though DeAngelo had top 5 talent, he was drafted 19th overall by the Tampa Bay Lightning. And most scouts, because of his colorful past, actually had him in the second round. And so after only 2 years in the organization, including a very productive AHL year, DeAngelo would be traded to Arizona for only a second round pick, even though he was hands down one of the best defensive prospects in the entire NHL. And then, after only one season in Arizona, DeAngelo would be traded once again in a package deal for Derek Stepan. And today, DeAngelo seems to be maturing into an entirely different player. With an extremely impressive 53 points and 68 games, he has a very bright future. And for someone who had so many issues, hopefully has grown past them. Next, we have Kirill Kapanoff. And Kapanoff, heading into the 2010 NHL Draft, was considered to be a potential top 3, if not first overall consideration, as he was developing into a star in Russia and had the tool set to be an elite goal scoring winger in the NHL. Because as a 16-year-old, he put up 11 points in 7 U18 games. However, this is where the drama would begin. And to start, he would get into a bunch of contract issues with the KHL that resulted in him being suspended, so instead, he came to the QMJHL for his draft year. And in his draft year, Kapanoff would join the Russian junior team, but would be dismissed from the team due to attitude issues. And so, he returned to the QMJHL. However, Kapanoff would be verbally unhappy with his ice time, resulting in him getting healthy scratched during the playoffs. And so with limited games, Kirill would still put up 23 points, 10 goals, and 22 games. So not terrible production, but definitely not top 10 upside. And the cherry on top would be that Kapanoff would be dropped from his agent right before the draft. And so Kapanoff went from a potential first overall pick to being drafted in the third round by the New York Islanders. And today, Kirill is playing in Denmark. He had a short stint in the AHL, played in the ECHL, and then went overseas. But who knows how his career would have turned out if he had the right mindset. And lastly, we have the infamous Josh Hosang. Because Hosang would see a massive drop because of his apparent attitude issues. And Hosang was a highly gifted scoring winger who would actually outscore Connor McDavid in minor midget. And so after joining the OHL, Hosang would have massive expectations. And he would live up to them, as he put up 44 points in his rookie season and would be highly regarded as a top 10 pick for the 2014 NHL Draft. But in his draft year, we'd start to see rumors emerge, as Hosang would be a part of Team Canada in the U17s, but wouldn't even be invited to the U18s as a top talent, which of course was a massive red flag. And this had to do with apparent attitude issues, and this same theme would continue, as Hosang would be let off every tournament list even after being drafted and being a top talent in the CHL. Because even though Hosang would put up a very impressive 85 points in 67 games, which is top 10 production, Hosang nearly fell out of the first round as he'd be drafted by the Islanders at number 28. Which also had to do with poor draft interviews and internal communications about Hosang's apparent attitude issues. And today, Hosang has been experiencing the same old story. As he has all the talent in the world, but keeps getting sent down every year. And Hosang has been getting so frustrated that he's literally sat out parts of the season and protests to be traded, and has even cleared waivers. So on top of having the audacity to ask Mary Lemieux to wear his number 66, when he himself is not an NHL player yet, Hosang is a very polarizing player who has all the skill in the world. But anyways guys, has your team ever had a player with attitude issues? Let me know. And press subscribe for some more awesome content. We are on the road for 20K, so let's crush it. I know we can. Again, follow me on Twitter. I'm going to be announcing giveaways there. Link will be down below. Anyways, guys, I hope everyone's doing well. See you guys later.